Alright, girls, who was your first crush?
Luke Oresti or Zach Tawil?
I think it was Luke Oresti.
Kayla, who was your first crush at Mount?
Zach.
Who was your first crush at Mount?
Leo Say.
Luke Fraser.
Alright, April, who was your first crush?
Max Shelton.
Who was your first crush at Mount?
Leo.
Michael Kugi.
Johnny.
Will Vestergaard.
Max Cowie. He went to Melbourne High.
No.
Ziggy.
Ziggy? Yeah. Nah, respect.
Max.
Farhan.
My first crush was Luke Fraser.
It was actually Connor Wall in year 7.
Connor Wall.
Who was your first crush at Mount?
I have to say that'd be Johnny Mutsius.
Sean Flanagan.
We just call him S.
Who was your first crush at Mount?
Benjin. Crystal Zhang. Portia Hayward.
Portia Hayward.
Zach Tawil, easy.
Your first crush at Mount?
Max Cowie.
Crush at Mount Waverley, please.
Miss Salon.
ET, mate, who's your first crush at Mount?
I don't know, to be honest.
That's all right. Coward. School captain here, Aria Trevetti. Who was your first crush at Mount?
It's going to be Crystal. Crystal Zhang.
Crystal Zhang's?
Charlotte.
Deanna Pat.
Bella Simone.
Yeah.
Who was your first crush at Mount?
Alicia Farah.
Thank you, man.
Probably Alexia.
Oh, probably a teacher.
Olio.
I was Deanna.
Fraser, who was your first crush at Mount?
Legally, I have to say Emily. Same thing as Luke, legally Grace Beards.
Ben, who was your first crush at Mount?
Esther Kong.
Judy, who was your first crush at Mount? And don't say Jess.
Probably Duma.
Probably Deanna.
Oh, come on, everyone knows this. Amanda Cordero.
I'm answering Bia.
Hey, Amanda, if you're watching this.
Yeah, I'm still single.
Now, lads, who's your first crush at Mount?
Baran.
Baran?
Yeah, Baran.
Baran?
It's Stephanie.
Who's your first crush at Mount, mate?
Deanna.
It's got to be Cassie Foster.
Cassie Foster?
Winnie?
Connor, who's your first crush at Mount?
It's going to have to be Kaylin O'Reilly.
Pipes, mate, who's your first crush at Mount?
Probably Maka Izzo.
Maka Izzo? No, good man.
Emily Harvey? Same.
Emily Harvey?
He was Bia.
Bia?
Yeah.
And I can't pronounce his last name. I don't think he was here in year 7, but it was still him.
The boys?
Good man.
So, Tech, who was your Mount Waverley first crush?
Probably Maka Izzo.
It's a teacher. Yeah, I don't want to say who it is.
It's a teacher too. But I can't say.
Fair enough.
Ian Davidson.
Is yours a teacher as well?
I gotta go. Yeah, okay. Teacher.
We're not. I'm doing it.
I'll say loud and proud. Caitlin O'Reilly.
Nice.
Crush at Mount.
Oh, I don't know. Bia?
Oh, year 7. Victoria, maybe.
Who was your first crush at Mount Waverley?
Your mum.
Who?
Hangs out. Emily Harvey.
Allah. Probably Esther. Esther Cole.
Okay, thank you.
God, who was your first crush? Madeline Carcosis.
Before we start, sir, do you have any comments?
Yes, out of uniform, you're a disgrace as usual.
Which students would you least likely want to date your children?
Oh, you haven't met my son. Anything can. Yeah, he's good enough.
Yeah.
He can handle it.
Anyone. Yeah, okay.
I'm gonna message Mako after this and tell him to cut this entire interview out.
So last year, you were quite angry in your interview. Is that gonna be replicated here?
Yes.
Also, on average, how long does it take you to read ET's essay and what percentage can you actually read?
I can read about 23%, I wanna say, we'll be specific. Probably takes about an hour. Just to give you a bit of an estimate, usually takes me about 5 minutes to read one.
Sounds about right. Out of your two cats, Charlie and Rosie, which one is your favourite?
Charlie. My sister's gonna cry.
Who would you least like to date your child?
Least like to date my child? Or anyone of you three?
What? Why is that?
I just don't think you guys would suit my boys.
Fair enough, thank you very much.
Which student would you least like to date your child?
I'll say Duluth.
Yeah? Why?
You know Duluth, right?
Regrettably.
So that's, you know.
Which student would you least like to date your child?
Connor Wall.
Connor Wall. Any reasoning?
I think he knows the reasons why.
Which student would you least like to date your child?
My answer is Nico.
Here we go.
And he wouldn't get the chance, first of all. If I knew that Nico was hanging around one of my children, I would take up boxing.
right.
Yeah, it's a sport. Anyway.
Which students would you least likely want to date your son? Or if you had a daughter?
No one who was irresponsible, so basically half my PE class.
Which student would you least like to date one of your children?
I don't have kids, but I reckon Connor Wall. And the reason being, the amount of times I need to remind Connor about his uniform. And I think that anyone dating Connor would be forever reminding Connor about what he needs to do next and what's messy around the house. I have a theory, okay? During remote learning in term 3, I actually think that Nikki Kim may have been Uber Eats delivering during the day.
Interesting.
Interesting. See if there's any truth to that matter.
We're here with the notorious Nikki Kim here. And Miss McKinnon had a conspiracy theory that during online school, you were Uber driving and doing Uber Eats.
Yeah.
Do you have any comments on this?
No, you've got to make that dosh, brother.
Miss Hill, which student would you least like to date your child?
It has to be Mitch Fresher.
Mitch Fresher?
Mr. C, which student would you least like to date your child?
All of them.
Anyone that you would like to date your child?
Someone like me, perfect.
Yes?
You're perfect. Mr. Myers, which student would you least like to date your child?
Which student would I least like to date my child?
You.
Me?
Yeah, hands down.
I'm a good kid.
Thankfully, I don't have any children, so we won't have to cross this bridge, but yeah.
Which student would you not want to date your child?
I don't think I'd want any of you dating my child.
It depends. It has to be you, sir. At least, you'd be the one that would be allowed, because at least you're polite.
Fair enough, sir. Thank you very much.
Mr. Wall, which student would you least like to date your daughter?
Oh, that is a good question. I'll get Evan.
Evan?
Evan. Yeah.
Any reason?
Just Evan. That's all I need to say, I think. I think that's fair.
Who's most likely to make it?
You, Lucan.
Who's most likely to go to jail?
You, Lucan.
Who is the biggest disgrace?
Oh, it's easy. Yesh.
Which students do you think are knocking boots?
There's been actually a few couples I've been a bit surprised about. Luke Fraser and Emily Harvey, pretty cute together.
Yeah, they've been going strong for a couple of years now.
A couple of years now, yeah.
And which students do you ship together?
Do I what? Yourself? Keeney.
All right, Keeney. Yeah.
Who's knocking boots?
Who's knocking boots? well, obviously we've got Steph and Sneth, and they've been long-time friends, the power couple. And then we have Grace and Ziggy, obviously, you know, the perfect couple. But I think, and then obviously there is, there's Ethan and Alicia, so they were having a little bit of a cuddle in my bio.
Alicia will be glad to hear that on this video.
Do you have a favourite moment from this year?
Going back to year 8, I fell down the stairs at the JS, and there was a few students that helped me, and I think that's just been really nice to see that those type of students can have a bit of a good heart.
Who's got the rudest head in year 12?
Well, you guys are pretty tame, but I did see Larkin's hair walking through
the corridor.
It's disgusting. I don't think it's been washed since pre-COVID times, to be perfectly honest, but anyway.
James Larkin, what are your thoughts on Mr. Morton's comments about your hair?
Well, I think I know a thing or two about Mr. Morton, and he'd never challenge me to the WBC Heavyweight Championship. And I think I'd like to formally challenge him to fight in a boxing ring. Anytime, anywhere, Mr. Morton, I'm coming for you.
Mr. Ritchie, which student would you least like to date your child?
I still want a DNA test.
What's your favourite moment with our year level?
I reckon it's going to be our last class on Tuesday. It's yet to happen. Well, actually, no, by the time this gets aired, it would have happened.
And are we going to do prac?
Yes.
How does it feel knowing all the girls have had a crush at you at one point?
Pass.
Most likely make it.
Oh, Tory.
Oh, for what?
Something just talking, just like a lot of talking.
Last year in the year 12 video, you said that after last year's cohort, you're going to resign.
Still surprised you're still here, to be honest with you.
In last year's video, you said that this cohort won't top last year's cohort. Do you have any comments about this comment?
I reckon the year level below us will be anywhere as good as we were.
No way. You don't take the cake.
I resigned, actually, when I did. That's it. End of year 12 for me. I'm going with you guys to wherever you guys go.
No comment.
No comment.
There's some news.
Would you like to spill?
Just watch the space.
Who do you think will duck year 12?
Is that D-U-C-K, duck?
No, D-U-X.
Oh, it's a dyslexia again, I'm really sorry. Whoever's worth it.
Who do you think will ducks year 12?
I know that we've had some people working really, really hard. Oh, I'm probably going to go with Rachel Tan on this one. Yeah, it's not taking away from anyone else, but Rachel's put a lot of effort in. So good luck to Rachel and everyone else.
Who do you think will ducks in year 12?
Rachel Tan.
Yeah. The common answer.
Oh, yes. Well, she's been a strong student from the very beginning.
Who's most likely to go to jail?
Mr. C.
Fair enough.
Students?
Yeah, as a student.
Oh, there's so many of them. Well, Sirtak?
Sirtak? What's he going to do?
Something not very legal.
Who's most likely to go to jail?
Shoo, where do I start? That's a tough one. You need to give me some time to think about that.
That's fair.
Who is most likely to make it in life after school?
Dooleth. He's really personable. He's a bit of a social butterfly. Does my head in PE class. However, I feel like that'll get him far in life.
Who is the most likely to be famous?
Most likely to be famous? Well, I think there's going to be a few. Famous for the wrong reasons, I reckon. I reckon Nico would get into a business.
Oh, Nico. Yeah. Does this link with most likely to go to jail?
Probably.
Yes. Okay. Your favourite student at Mount?
It has to be Nathan. I mean, Ethan.
Ethan Constantine?
Yes, yes.
Big ET?
Almost same name. Yeah, same name as my child, Nathan, so.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Who is most likely to go to jail?
Gatsios. No, to be a prison warden. Like, yeah. You'd work there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And give us your thoughts on the D's win in the AFL.
Oh, look, it's the proudest moment I've ever had as a human being. Second to, obviously, me taking you guys out with Mr. Myers earlier this year. And us nearly taking down Vermont.
That was a good
So, news. Yeah, it was a fantastic set. I actually saw Petrarca at the supermarket on Wednesday night. And
did you go fangirling?
I was too afraid to. I was too scared to. So, anyway.
Favourite moment of the year level?
Oh, it has to be when you tried to organise the Year 10 history class for a walkout, only to walk out alone for me to lock the door on you.
It's about sending a message, sir.
There was a clear message, but it wasn't the one you wanted.
Thanks, sir. Dap me up.
100%
massive.
And who's your favourite teacher at Mount Waverley?
Mr. Richie.
Richie.
Definitely Mrs. Keatley.
Miss Brighton.
Probably Miss Challenger.
Miss Brunner.
Who's your favourite teacher?
Andrew Morton.
Morris and Natasha.
Alan Ritchie.
Miss Dracklich, obvious reasons.
Yeah, Miss Dracklich as well.
Have to be Ian Shore.
Ian Davidson.
It's got to be Mr. Davidson.
I've thought long and hard about this, and I'm going to have to say Morton.
Miss Bennett.
Who's your favourite teacher at Mount?
Mr. Morton.
Miss Challenger.
Mine's Goat Myers, obviously.
Goat Myers.
Thorny.
Miss Reed.
Yeah, Mr. Donovan.
Mr. Say.
Miss Daly Ugly.
Mr. Myers.
Favourite teacher at Mount Waverley?
Miss Lucas.
Morton. Mr. Morton.
Ooh, Mr. Wall.
Mr. Wall.
Yeah, probably Ed Sheeran.
Mr. Wall.
Mr. Wall.
They're all great.
Although he said some mean things about me, it's Mr. Ritchie.
Yeah, Mr. Ritchie.
Mr. Vaughn.
Gotta be Mr. Ritchie.
Gotta be Mr. Ritchie, man.
Miss Pugsley.
Miss D.
Miss Phelan for sure.
Mr. Mullins.
Goat Myers.
She may not be here anymore, but Jan Pugsley, we all remember you.
By Mr. Newport.
Back in Jan Pugsley all the way.
AJ Morton for the win.
Who's your favourite teacher?
Probably Miss Hill.
Mr. Myers.
Maybe Mr. Line in year 7.
Mr. Beale.
Mr. Wall.
Bryden.
Probably Miss Hill.
Miss Hill as well.
Mr. Wall or Mr. Newport.
Miss Challenger.
Miss Challenger.
Probably Mr. Suter.
Miss Kamakawa.
Mr. Morton.
Liam Wall.
Mr. Myers. Mr. Wall.
We're late for school.
Don't worry, I know exactly who to pick up. I thought we were going to be like the school, so I just had to pick you guys up.
Yep.
Yeah. All right, let me play some songs here. Oh. With this song, I'm going to throw it back to your childhood, sir. Here we go.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. With a clack clack here and a clack clack there.
Pass me the phone, Connor. I've got a song.
There you go, sir.
It's going to be bad.
Oh, no.
cheer to the red and the white. Honor the name by day and by night. Lift that noble banner high. Shake down the thunder from the sky.
My name is Nick Andriopoulos. I'm year 12. I love this school and I came from Greece. I speak England very best.
Coffee or tea?
Tea.
Pineapple and pizza, thoughts?
Crime.
Does the tomato sauce belong in the fridge or the cupboard?
Cupboard.
Good questions.
Do you have a clock and know how to read it?
Yes.
So why are you never on time?
Shh.
Blokes, when you're at the back of the class, what is your favourite game to play?
Run.
Run?
I used to play Clash Royale, you know?
Clash Royale, good man.
Yeah, chess.
Chess master, grandmaster?
Do we have any comments on Alana?
She just went home with Wilson, so I'm not quite sure.
Who's Wilson?
Alana's ex-boyfriend.
That is Tay.
Hey girls, what's your favourite high school memory?
My suspension. Being friends with club promoter Crystal. Fridays.
Being a club promoter, what's your favourite club to go to?
Envy, use my guest list, Crystal's in.
Sandesh will be the best player in the world. How's it feel to have the biggest glow up in Mount Waverley?
Oh look, honestly, I think I've had a glow down. I was a bit of a specimen back in year 7.
Sirtak, how does it feel to have made every girl at this school cry in around year 7 and 8?
You know, like, put a lot of time and effort into that. I'm pretty proud of my achievements. You know, I'm still waiting for the trophy to arrive, you know, so getting that one made, but everyone that I made cry means a lot to me. Thank you very much.
I have no comment for that. He made me cry too.
Thank you.
All right, we got 2011's NAB Oz Kicker of the Year here. Can you give us a bit of a shimmy?
Nah.
Have a look at this. Give it a go, on, son. Give it a go. That is beautiful.
Go.
Wolsey has topped you for favourite teacher. How does that make you feel?
Everyone feels sorry for him.
Yeah.
Can I just ask a personal question?
Yeah.
What hair conditioner do you use?
Absolutely no idea. Just whatever's in the house.
Give us any comments on the time you went to the movies with Mitchell.
No comment.
Mitch, mate, can we please get your opinions on you taking Melanie to the movies?
Mate, no comment on that.
No comment on that, fair enough.
I'm here with the school captains here, Lila and Aria. So what have the thoughts been of this year?
It's been a pretty difficult year. Oh God. We've all done a really good job. It's been a terrible year, so to get through it together is pretty amazing achievement.
Look, we've seen some of the Year 12s do a lot of things over the years, and it's shown a lot of perseverance in lockdown and in real school, so it's great to see that.
Do you have a final address to the Year 12s before we leave?
Just good luck for the future. We've loved working with you all, so good luck.
When you guys get that Grammy, just remember to shout at MWSC.
Yeah, you got any tips for the Melbourne Cup?
Don't bet.
And a final message.
Well, actually, mine is about betting, Luca. Yeah, and so. My moral is there's three morals in life, right? Number one, always back the top in the last in Sydney. Secondly, always back a double four. And thirdly, if W Pike is in the last race at in Perth Racing, just put your house on it because you can't lose.
Any final thoughts for our year level?
It's been awful for you, but good luck. You'll be successful anyway. Well done.
Do you have a final message for this cohort?
Just give it your best. It's been a bit of a challenging year, and I think you guys have been so good and so awesome at being resilient. So just keep on going because you will get there.
And a final message to our year level.
No matter what happens, all right, you can persevere and you will survive. All right, whatever. All right, I do believe in you. Andrew, I'm not so sure, all right? No, honestly, it's been a dreadful year. It'll make you stronger, all right?
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
All right, you.
Final message to our year.
In all honesty, guys, it's been a bit of an interesting couple of years for you, particularly this year, but keep being yourselves. You're a wonderful bunch. You're quite a small cohort compared to other cohorts, and all the best for the future. Go and kill it outside in the outside world and be good to each other. And yeah, enjoy it.
You know what, guys? It's really been a pleasure. 4 years. You guys were probably like, oh gosh, we've got Miss McKinnon again as our head of school. But it's really been fun to watch you all grow and mature into young adults. And you know, I think you can walk away with your heads held high. So congrats to everyone. Well done, guys.
Thank you very much.
Our own. But now it's up to us to
It's been calling out to me. That is where I should be.